Before we begin, I'd like to thank the sponsor of today's video, Raid Shadow Legends. The majority of today's cargo aircraft are specially designed versions of existing passenger aircraft. By filling the main cabin with freight instead of seats, cargo operators can use these to ferry all kinds of goods around the world much faster than by land or sea. But what about outsized cargo? Well, for extra-large objects, European manufacturer Airbus has developed the Beluga family. But why is its most recent iteration not based on a more modern aircraft? Airbus's first outsized cargo aircraft was officially named the A300-600ST, ST standing for Super Transporter. However, after its introduction in the mid-1990s, it received a popular nickname, which has stuck ever since. Because its bulbous fuselage resembles a particular whale species, the aircraft is now widely known as the Beluga. By 1999, Airbus had produced 5 of these striking aircraft, which were based on its first ever commercial airliner, the A300. The Beluga is a heavily modified version of this game-changing twin jet and allows Airbus to transport outsized components between its sites across Europe. After 2 decades of service, Airbus began the process of modernizing its aging Beluga fleet. Its new outsized cargo aircraft made its first test flight in July 2018 and is known as the Beluga XL. This larger and more modern behemoth entered service in January 2020 and is based on the Airbus A330-200F. But why didn't Airbus use the next-generation A330-800 as a base aircraft instead? Looking to pass the time at the airport or even during a flight? Check out Raid Shadow Legends for hours of entertainment. Raid is the first game to bring a true console-level experience to your device, and they've set the bar so high you might not want to play anything else. This game lets you collect hundreds of heroes to customize for battle. I've been playing Raid for a while now, and Tervold and Norog are two of the champions I've been using. Tervold deals damage as one of the hardest hitters in the whole game, making him great just about everywhere. Meanwhile, Norog is a brutal defense champion and all about shutting down active skills and buffs. I mean, just look at what they can do with their weapons. Wow. Yeah, I wouldn't want to be on the other end of either of these guys. The game is great if you want to pass the time and escape to a world that's fun and exciting, playing with other people from around the world. All of the game's new content makes for endless opportunities for exploration. And this month, Raid's also got new champions to collect from fragments in the Doom Tower and a load of events and competitions to take part in. They also just released a ton of amazing new clan features and improvements, including new quests, a new clan shop, and new benefits for every clan member. Get a huge head start in Raid by clicking the link in the description or scan this QR code. New players will get the epic hero Chonaroo, amazing in the Doom Tower, by the way. You'll also get 200,000 silver, 1 XP boost, 1 energy refill, and 1 ancient shard so you can summon an awesome champion right away. These extra rewards can be found in your inbox for the next 30 days only. Thanks again to Raid Shadow Legends for sponsoring this video. Now, on with the rest of the show. First of all, it's worth briefly touching on how the A330-200 compares to its next-generation counterpart. The -200 entered service with Korean Air in 1998 as a short fuselage version of the original -300. This had been introduced by French carrier Air Inter 4 years previously. Meanwhile, the A330-800 is the smallest variant in the ultra-modern A330neo series. Kuwait Airways received the first delivery of this type last October, with Uganda Airlines following 2 months later. Much like its older counterpart, the short fuselage -800 entered service after the standard longer version. In the A330neo's case, the longer model is designated as the -900. Let's look at how the -200 compares with the -800. Both jets are 58.82 meters in length. However, the -200 has a wingspan of 60.3 meters, while the -800 has a span of 64 meters. If we compare the passenger versions of each jet, the A330-800 is capable of about 12% greater range than the -200. As we can see, there's little to separate the A330-200 and -800 in terms of their specifications. Both have similar dimensions and capacities, while the newer Dash 800 edges performance-based aspects such as range, as one might expect. So why wouldn't the Dash 800 Neo be used as the new Beluga? Well, Airbus had several good reasons to opt for the older Dash 200 when developing the Beluga XL. One key factor is the fact that the A330-200 already has an established freight variant. This makes it easier to convert than the Dash 800, which is yet to see such a development. While the Dash 800 outperforms the Dash 200 in terms of range, this aspect is less important in terms of Beluga XL operations. Indeed, most of its trips take place within Europe anyway. Furthermore, this advantage would likely be less significant in the event of a conversion, as cargo aircraft generally have lower ranges than their passenger-carrying counterparts. Finally, time is also an important factor in this discourse. When looking at Airbus's timescales in its rollout of the Beluga XL, the established A330-200 was much more conducive to getting to market sooner. The new outsized cargo aircraft entered service almost a year before the A330-800. As such, using the newer variant as a basis for the Beluga XL would have negatively impacted the project's timeframe. Thus, for now, the A330-NEO remains a passenger-focused family of jets. What do you make of the Airbus Beluga XL? Do you think it should have been based on the new A330-800 instead of the existing A330-200? Let us know your thoughts in the comments. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles and a podcast every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe before you go.